Hello there. Welcome back to Python programming course we are discussing about, and in this session we are going to discuss about the Python packages. So far you have seen that we are using the Python for writing down programs to do number of different things. But remember, not every programming language or not any programming language can contain all that is developed for that particular language. What I mean to say is, Python by itself or by its installation does not contain every single library that is written for it. And every day, every new day, the developers across the world are creating some new packages, creating some new functionalities with Python, which can be added to increase the usability of the Python at the end usage. So these things are called as Python packages. And we can install the Python packages as and when needed into our installation so as to be able to use them. So let's see what are the different packages and how to use them. So I said, let's see what are the different packages, but that's a very, very big overstatement, because there are so many Python packages available that I just cannot fathom them, or I can never list them out in a slideshow. So what I have done is I have included some of the most popular Python packages which we use, which number of different people use in their everyday life, in their everyday programming tasks. So one such package is called TinyDB, which is a very small database used for Python. Then there is NumPy, which is used for matrix operation in Python. OpenCV, you may or may not know about, but it's very popular one. This is Open Computer Vision Library. So it is used for performing computer vision applications with Python. SciPy adds some complex MATLAB like mathematical functions and algorithms to the Python. Pygame is used to create audios, videos and synthesizing different things. PyQt and PyGTK are the two GUI making libraries in Python. Requests is one of the most popular HTTP library written for Python, and Schedule is also one of the very popular scheduler algorithm. As said, these are not the only packages. Don't even consider that these are the only packages for Python. I have just listed some Python packages, or I must immediately call it few Python packages. So because it's just few numbers that I'm showing here. Point is not the package itself, because no Python course in this world can cover every single package. There are more than 2000 different packages available for Python, and you cannot just experiment with every one of them. But you will experiment with those packages which you need the most. Point we are making here is, how do we install these packages? So do you manually download them and do something with them, or what? So to install these packages, we can use the Python Package Manager. In short, it is also called as PIP, because PIP is a script, is a small program present inside Python, which can access the Python Package Manager, which is nothing but an internet-based site, or instead of saying site, let me say a server, where all the different packages are hosted or maintained. The website is PyPy, or the Python Package Index for Python. It is pypy.org. For example, let's say if you have created your own package, then what you can do is you can simply upload them here, and people across the world can download that package directly into their installation by simply running a very small command. So let's first search the package we are discussing about. So let's say TinyDB. Okay. So Python Package Manager has a script built inside the installation of your Python. Let's navigate through the installation. While doing the installation, if you remember the very first video where I have shown, I had particularly mentioned and forced you to check on a box called Add Python to the path variable. What that does is, whatever the scripts are present in Python folder are directly accessible from command prompt. If they are not accessible, then you need to find your program files, your Python installation, scripts folder, and then there is something called as PIP. So this is the PIP. PIP is nothing but the package manager program, which you can run directly. I don't think so anything would be easy to understand out of it. So let's just run it. It's an application made in Python. So how do we use PIP? It's very simple. If I have to install TinyDB in my Python, all I have to do is open a command prompt and type PIP install TinyDB. So CMD. Assuming you have not taken the necessary actions required for adding the Python to the path variable, what I'll have to do then is CD, program files, CD, Python 36, CD, scripts. This is to be done when I have not added the Python to the path while installing, and then just type PIP install TinyDB. The same command will contact package manager, download the particular package for you, and then install it for you. Now it could not be installed because the access is denied at a particular location. To avoid that, in Windows, on Linux you can definitely use sudo before the command. On Windows, type command and then run as administrator. Again, I'll go to the same location, cd:\, then cd program files, cd python 36, and cd scripts, and then PIP install TinyDB. So it will collect the TinyDB package, install it, installation is done. If the installation of Python itself was done correctly, then you don't need to be present at that particular location. C, program files, Python, scripts, it's not necessary. You can directly run it from any place. Let's see, schedule. That's a scheduler package, very interesting one. So PIP install schedule, that's the command. PIP install schedule. It will again, in the same way, collect the schedule package, download it and install it. So that's how you can download and install any particular Python package in your installation as you want and use it in your programming. How to use it? Most of the times, every package page lists down how you can use that particular package. So we'll see how to use the scheduler package in our next video. Thanks for watching this video.